Hello, YouTube. This is Tiki Bomber here, and there's several things I actually want to talk about, but because the songs that I use right now are very short, I'm just going to let this playthrough or this playlist from No Copyright Sounds go through. I'll put the description of each song in the or the link of each song in the description below, so you guys can check out the No Copyright Sounds for your own videos. So let's go ahead and get right into it. First and foremost, Berkeley protests, or I should say the Berkeley riot, because that is exactly what happened. What I've seen was not only the silencing of somebody who has a different opinion from you, but the actual people calling themselves Antifas or anti-fascists acting as fascist individuals themselves. That alone just screams to me, well, that's a fucking hypocrite right there. You might as well be calling the kettle black as you're in the process. But the issue is the people that they're calling fascists are not fascists. We're not Nazis. All right. And if you actually understood the real term of a Nazi, of being a Nazi, if you actually understood the real term of being a fascist, you would realize that you are doing the very thing that you're fighting against. You are being the fascist. Even without realizing it. And that's harmful. It is a very harmful, very dangerous idea to have. And while there are liberals who have actually come out and said, yeah, this is a very dangerous thing, you have people like Sarah Silverman who sits there and says, yeah, keep fighting the fascists. We will win. We will survive. Military will support us. And that's the thing. The military will not support you. They will not back you up. And I'm saying that as somebody who has experience in the military. I'm saying that as somebody who speaks to a lot of people who have experience in the military. The military will not defend you. The military will defend its country from you. From people who are deemed to be its threat. And the only people right now who are deeming to be the country's threat at this moment are the people running around calling everyone a fascist. So I don't know why you think the military is going to defend your ass when you're the one sitting there causing these problems to begin with, making it a threat to be dealt with. And if the military gets involved, then you can say goodbye to your freedoms, because we're going to have militia law come through. And guess what? They're not going to let you just run around in the middle of the street, in the middle of the streets at the middle of the night, throwing protests and stuff. They're going to knock your ass down. Arrest you, possibly even shoot you and kill you on sight, and there'd be nothing you say, nothing you do to fight against them to get that. So there's that. Next is going to be the Women's March. And while I have done some looking into the Women's Rights March itself, I was not 100% on board with that due to the fact that everything that they want to bring into the Women's Rights March is all for Western society only, including something I'm strongly against, Sharia law. And the reason why I'm against Sharia law is because Sharia law actually takes away women's rights. It takes away your right to vote. It takes away your right to walk out into the middle of the street and being by yourself. It takes away your rights to go into these shops that you want to go into without having the threat of being harassed or race come through. Sharia law is actually taking away women's rights, and I'm strongly advocating against that. If you, as a feminist, are in support of Sharia law, you cannot call yourself a feminist because you're taking away our goddamn rights. And I will not stand for that. I want my rights. I will fight you tooth and fucking nail for my rights to stop Sharia law from being processed in the United States. And I am going to continue to fight until it is done. And I know plenty of women who are feminists who are against Sharia law. So, if you're for Sharia law and you want to sit there and call yourself a feminist, don't. Because you're doing nothing but the opposite of what feminism is about. And that is about women's rights. For women, by women. And as I've stated, I will fight you tooth and fucking nail for that. I will put an end to Sharia law in the United States as quickly as I can. And I really hope that the governments out there will do the same thing, because they know, they've known from the history of the struggle of women from the 1920s and then in the 1960s and 70s for the rights that women have today. And then some with additional rights and bonuses that women have above men to boot. So yeah, I will fight against Sharia law, because that is the one thing that is going to take away women's rights that women have fought for over almost a century ago to date. So, yeah, don't call yourself a feminist if you're for Sharia law. Just don't, okay? Next, there is the whole issue with the Tommy, Lauren, and Thunderfoot drama that I've seen going around as well. Now, both Tommy Lauren, or known as previously as Lauren Southern, and Thunderfoot had put up videos. Tommy had put up a video about the riots that were happening in Berkeley. I think it was Berkeley. It could be the Women's March riots. I can't remember which one it was. And then Thunderfoot was calling Tommy out as being a liar. Both videos were taken down by a DMCA claim. This claim being pushed in by somebody called Susie. Now, I didn't see what the name was actually unblurred, so I cannot make a valid argument about this. But if either Tommy, Lauren, or Thunderfoot want to correct me on this, go ahead and do so. I think the people who have pushed in on this DMCA claim are the same people who had put in the petition letter to stop the red pill from being shown in Melbourne, Australia. These are the same, it's an individual or a group of people, much like Anonymous, who are pushing to silence individuals whose opinions are considered toxic with the movement that they represent. And that would be against men itself. As a feminist, I've stated before in the past, I have no problems with men. I have no problems with men going with their own rights. I have no problems with men going their own way. I also have no problems with supporting men in obtaining the rights that they deserve. All right? But that's just my opinion as a feminist. And this is something that I think that people need to understand, that this is seemingly a theory, possibly a conspiracy theory, about Susie Smith being a group of feminists who are remaining anonymous under the pseudonym name of Susie Smith to silence people like Tommy Lauren, to silence people like Thunderfoot, and to silence things like how petition for the red pill to be canceled back in, I want to say, October? Could have been late September, early October. I could be wrong about that, so go ahead and let me know if I'm wrong in the comment section below. This is just some of the things I actually did want to cover, and as I said before, I haven't had very much time to go into it. There's been a lot of stuff happening in this past week alone. I mean, you have women trying to march for Sharia rights, for Sharia law to exist in the United States. And the only kind of protection that women will have under Sharia law is if they are constantly escorted by a man 24/7. And that man has to be a family member. Unfortunately, not everybody has, are married or have men in their families. So that right there in the United States will nick about a good portion of women out there who would probably be in support of this regardless and just, like, throw that logic out the window. I'm going to go on and continue on further with this. Women's rights have always been about women for women. Women fighting for women. Women supporting women. Women helping women. This is the feminist movement all in its own self. Women should fight for themselves. We should not rely on the protection of men. We should not rely on the protection from the government. We should fight for ourselves. And if that means taking up self-defense, then take up fucking self-defense. Learn to protect yourself. I mean, that's what self-defense classes are. They're about protecting yourself, not sitting there babying you into fighting. If you don't like the idea of fighting, you have other means to protect yourself, such as pepper sprays and basic defense. Having your phone on hand with 911 at the ready. So as soon as somebody jumps you, like they jump in front of you and saying, hey, or, you know, whatever, you're ready. Going out with a group of friends and making sure your friends know that you are to leave with them. So, yeah, that's all going to be stuff to think about, too.